wear and tear, or so-called degenerative changes of the spine, can occur in a variety of locations, most commonly in the neck and low back regions. It can cause a variety of symptoms ranging from back or neck pain to arm and leg pain, and sometimes even be associated with neurologic deficits such as numbness and or weakness. Initial management of such conditions involves initial trials of non-operative care. These can include anything from physical therapy, traction, to a trial of injection. It's only when these non-operative measures fail that surgery can at times become a reasonable option for patients. In the neck, degenerative changes such as a disc herniation can occur over a single level or over several levels. They can also vary in severity and also in location. If a disc herniation occurs centrally in the neck or cervical region, it can cause pressure on the spinal cord. This in turn can cause either arm or leg symptoms, ranging from weakness to incoordination to gait imbalance. If a disc herniation occurs on the side, either on the right or the left, it can cause arm symptoms on that particular side. This can also range in nature from pain to numbness to weakness. Treatment is tailored to the specific scenario, depending on the duration of symptoms, the severity of symptoms, and the imaging findings. Wear and tear related changes occur most commonly in the low back area involving the lumbar spine. These changes can include wear on the discs, the joints, and the ligaments supporting the integrity of the spine. A disc herniation, as is shown here, can occur, for instance, on one side. In this situation, we would often see back pain with associated leg pain. In more severe cases, there can also be associated numbness and or weakness involving that side. At Ohio State, we particularly specialize in treating complex spinal disorders. These can involve a variety of deformities of the spine. Broadly speaking, a deformity involves an abnormal curvature of the spine, either in the neck, thoracic, or lumbar areas. Depending on the nature and severity of the symptoms and the imaging findings, a tailored treatment program is initiated, often initially involving non-operative measures such as physical therapy and injections. In cases that do not respond to such measures, surgical intervention is offered as an option